House Kassido was once the most powerful ally of the Juvex rebel cell. Now they are their worst enemy, all due to a betrayal by the house's top generals. During the coup, the rebels' lead contact, Lyra Kassido, and her father, King Jeros, were captured and imprisoned. Rebel command has learned where they are being held under Kassido and Imperial guard. Many of the people of Kassido are still loyal to their king. If the rebels can rescue the royal family, they may be able to pull a lot of them to their side. As such, the Juvex rebel cell has sent four of its best operatives to rescue them. They are Pejix Rabble, whose hacking of Imperial data led to the large amount of information the rebels have had, Dom Plang, whose deft use of heavy weapons allowed the rebels to escape from Zarya, Viv Ebbs, whose medical skills have been useful in their relations with both House Kellerman and the ex-slaves, and Jihad Alki, who was... special.
It's a trap!
Pejix Rabble's abilities included Master of Disguise and one more thing. Because of his experience, he got one upgrade card, and he chose Sneak Attack. Dom Plang had Covering Fire and Forceful Attack. His experience allowed him to also take Press the Attack. Viv Ebbs had Liquid Courage and Damn It, I'm a Doctor, not a... and he chose Hair of the Dog as his upgrade. And Jihad Alki had his catchphrase, It's a Trap! And Outside the Box, where he usually thought. He also got the upgrade Distrustful. They were going to need to break through some minor defensive works, so they took the Shadow Raptor pirate ship as a blockade runner. Captain Cog had just declared it fit for flying. They had a layout for the prison facility the king and princess would likely be in. They landed nearby, and headed toward it. Viv and Jihad were in the front. Ahead, they spotted three probe droids keeping a lookout. Pejix went first, hiding behind some rubble and using his disguise ability to hide. Quick game note. Viewers may notice that the miniature doesn't match the character as Pejix is a Soliston. However, it's the only mini that looks cool enough to be him, so we're going with it. Think of it as part of his disguise or something. Anyway, back to the story. The probe droids detected life forms moving around, so they passed by Pejix searching for them. Pejix made a sneak attack, destroying one of the probe droids. The others moved up and together took out the other one. The third one fired back at Pejix, grazing him. The operatives fired back and took it out. Dom ran past and checked out the computer console. It had information on the personnel inside, and it could be used to control the doors. He told the others, and they lined up at the door. When they were ready, he opened it. As soon as he did, Jihad was ready. He was always ready for any eventuality. He was also distrustful, so his shot landed hard and took out one of the stormtroopers. They fired back at him, but he was ready for that too, and he dodged. He and the doctor rushed in, and in the crossfire, they all took out the remaining stormtroopers. No sooner had they done this than three Kassido troopers entered the room, firing at the doctor, but he dodged the shots. The rebels were having incredible luck, so Dom Plang pressed the attack. He used it to wound all of them, and Jihad and the doctor mopped up after. Pejix wasted no time. He rushed to the computer console and looked it over. It operated the door to the prison cell, so he used his skill of one last thing, and he figured out how to open it. The door swished open, revealing Princess Lyra Kassido. And only Lyra Kassido. "Where's the king?" Pejix asked. Lyra approached him with a forlorn expression. "He's dead," she said. "The bastards killed him to make sure he wouldn't inspire followers of our empire on his side." "Why did they leave you alive?" Viv asked. An expression of deep anger grew across her face, one that said there was much to the story she didn't wish to discuss. Then she said, "They will soon if I do not get out of here now." Time was of the essence. Alarms were now blaring, and troopers of both the Empire and Kassido were running toward them. Pejix pointed the way to go. Dom led, taking cover and waiting for the stormtroopers who were running to cut them off. Jihad ran up. His distrustful nature was on high alert with all the doors having opened, and he was focused several times over. So he fired and blew away one of the stormtroopers. The others followed, Pejix guarding Lyra's body with his own. Lyra slipped by and ran for the ship while the others continued to stand in the way of any pursuers. The stormtroopers spread hits among a couple of them, but they took the wounds and ran to the ship. The stormtroopers pursued, Pejix dodging the shots, but Dom taking more hits along the way as he fired a few more shots before they all got into the ship and flew away. Their mission was complete, but the princess told them something that caught their attention. Her father had been developing weapons that would rival the Empire. She didn't know much about them, but she knew they would be dangerous in the wrong hands. They were now in those wrong hands, so she urged them to look into it. These weapons programs were recorded within the databanks of their base on Cordura. They should be able to get onto the world because the Kassido and Imperial fleets were busy fighting Kellerman. Security at the center should be light since the current administration didn't likely know that this information was hidden within the databanks of the station. And so they didn't take the time to even return to the rebel base. Instead, they went straight to Cordura. Along the way, the players got to choose new upgrades for their characters. Pejix chose Will Do Anything, which allowed him to perform a strain action without spending strain. Dom chose Push Them Back, which was exactly like it sounded. Viv chose Bold Distraction, which would allow him to make the enemy focus on himself rather than his comrades. And Jahat chose Master of Cosplay, because of course he did. Lyra gave them a clearance code to get into the atmosphere without raising an alarm, and instructed them on how to land near the base without being detected. They did, and they approached the doors. Just as she had promised, no one had seen them. Jahat wasn't satisfied. He was convinced that Lyra was sending them into a trap. Pejix didn't agree. He had been there when the Kassido coup had taken place, and he was certain that the royal family wanted revenge for this betrayal.
"So we're patsies," Dom suggested.
"We're not patsies," Pejix insisted. "Look, if we go down, she goes down with us."
"Or she leads them to us," Jahat said.
"This would be a huge elaborate plan to capture just 4 insignificant operatives," Pejix said.
"Insignificant, speak for yourself," Jahat said.
"I'll go in first," Pejix said to reassure them.
He opened the doors, gun drawn, then strolled in quietly. He could see in 2 directions. To the right, he spotted 3 guards and their commander. He moved closer, but he was stealthy enough that they did not yet see him. Viv sneaked in and took position around the corner. Dom stepped up to the edge of the stairs and filled the room with covering fire. It got the attention of the guards, but also suppressed them. They spotted Pejix and fired at him, but he dodged the shots and took a couple of them down. Jahat moved past and ran into the supply room, opening a crate to see what he could pull out. Using his special ability, he found stimulants, just the thing he was hoping for. Returning to the hall, he found that the last of the guards had been cleaned up. They pushed on before more arrived. Where they wanted to go was the control center. Jahat quickly put on his cosplay costume, pretending to be a scientist. He then made his way inside. Though he wasn't human, he was so convincing that he belonged that no one bothered him. Pejix also went inside in disguise, making his way to the center of the room. The engineers and guards inside thought they were hired help and ignored them. They were badly mistaken. Pejix pulled out his blaster and took down 2 of the guards in quick succession. The last remaining guard fired back, and he dodged all the blasts. Jahat continued his ruse and strolled by the guard, hacking into the computer system to get information they needed. Viv and Dom went back and covered the intersection, firing at the guards who were on their way, slowing them down. Pejix ran out of the control room, dashing down the hallway. He thought Jahat was on his tail, so he kept running, telling the others to come along too. But Jahat was still inside, calmly tapping away at the controls. The remaining guards hadn't noticed him, though, and were chasing Pejix down the hall, cutting the others off from the Calamari operative. The Kassido soldiers fired everything they had at them, wounding Dom badly enough to convince him that he had to run to the doctor, who did what he could for him. The remaining ones fired at Pejix, who amazingly rolled another dodge everything. But he didn't dodge the next. And now he was in horrible pain. He ran past the others, out the front door, asking Jahat where he was. Jahat was calmly strolling between the computers, gathering every bit of information he could. He told the others to leave without him.
"We can't do that," Pejix said.
"Really, you should," Jahat said.
"It's not for you, it's because you have the information we came here for," Pejix said.
"Oh, don't worry about that. I've got my own ride."
And once Jahat had everything he needed downloaded onto his external drive, he strolled over to the large window that looked out onto the hangar. He smashed it open and crawled through, strolling over to the ships that were there. He climbed in one of them and flew away. The others at first thought an enemy ship was following them and fired at it.
"Ah! It's a trap!"
Jahat shouted.
"Is that you?" Pejix asked.
"Yes, it's me. Someone's taking your ship and is shooting at me with it."
"That's us."
"Why are you shooting at me?"
"Never mind, just follow us. We're getting out of here."
The ships got out of the atmosphere and shot into hyperspace. Once they were away, they looked over what Jahat had acquired. It looked like the new Kassido government had indeed spotted the research on the new weaponry Lyra's father had approved. They were researching its viability at a lab on Asia Thora. Princess Lyra again agreed to go with them to show them a good way to sneak onto the planet and get to the research facility.
The ire toward the new Kassido government burned in her eyes. She had been spending time while she was alone on the ship trying to reach her contacts within Kassido, but they had all been swept out and executed. She was alone, except for these rebels who had the same goal as her. She had been raised to believe humans were superior, and other races made good slaves, but little more. These operatives were proving otherwise. They were currently upgrading their skills. Pijix chose would follow to the ends of the galaxy, which allowed him to take his turn directly after an ally. Dom Plang chose clear, which allowed him to activate an ally when the last enemy in a room was taken down. Viv took Call Me Bones, which allowed him to heal one extra damage. And Jihad Alki took Critical Thinking, which gave him more flexibility in the kind of damage he did. Asiathora was a little more well-protected than the other worlds they had been to, so they used their two ships to their advantage. They all loaded onto the new ship Jihad had just acquired, and had the Shadow Raptor fly ahead of them. As long as they remained close, the two ships would come across looking like one blip on the radar screen. As the Imperial and Kassido vessels chased after the blockade runner, the others broke off and dipped into the atmosphere. It worked perfectly, and they got to the ground without detection. They landed the ship behind a rise in the snowy terrain. The base was up ahead. Their objectives this time would be to locate information about the weapons Kassido was developing within their databanks. This could be accessed through any of the computer terminals either inside or outside the base. They would have to figure out which one it was. The rebels made their way toward it. Lyra had described the layout, so they had a general idea of what to expect inside. But they didn't know how many people would be there, so they approached cautiously. There were several control towers outside. These were known to have computer terminals that could be hacked into the mainframe, so Jihad and Viv checked out those to no avail. Pijix and Dom checked out the supply crate meanwhile, and found grenades. No one having found anything of immediate use, they moved on around the building to an alcove. Jihad checked the console outside while Pijix checked inside a room. A unit of Kassido guards were there, and they immediately opened fire on the intruder. The others joined Pijix and dispatched the guards with ease, though they took a little damage from the commander before finishing him off. Jihad, having found nothing outside, checked the console inside while the others moved on to the next doorway. Peeking inside, this time he found Imperial snowtroopers and Kassido soldiers, each with their own commanders. Pijix remained hidden, and closed the door again. As a game note, we were using Master of Disguise as a sort of remaining hidden ability as well. The operatives all gathered. Jihad still had not found what they were looking for, but he was narrowing down the possibilities. Pijix told them what was past the door they were near.
"It's a trap," Jihad said.
"Keep your voice down," Pijix whispered, "though I am inclined to agree with you." They only had moments to decide. The guards had likely heard the shots and would be coming their way soon to investigate. The operatives needed the information, and the nearby rooms were the most likely locations. So Pijix made sure everyone was ready, and he threw open the door. The Imperials had been headed their way, though they were taken completely by surprise when the door flew open. Pijix shot one of them. Then Dom threw in the grenade they had found, taking down three of the guards. The Imperial officer pulled back and fired at him. Viv jumped in and became a distraction, causing the guards to fire at him for 5 points of damage. The remaining soldiers closed in on the two Solistans. Dom spread the room with shots, covering them, but still took a little damage himself. That's when Pijix jumped in and did his sneak attack combined with one more thing, allowing him to take out two guards right away. The Kassido commander winged him, but did little damage, and Dom finished him off. The Imperial commander was the only one left, and he opened the door to tell the others to hurry to them, sounding the alarm as well. Jihad shot the officer in the back. Not very sportsmanlike, but effective. Pijix and Dom ran to the hallway, covering them. Snowtroopers appeared down the hall. "Check the computers while we hold them off," Pijix shouted. Viv checked the first one. It opened the doors to a small hallway which led to an adjoining chamber. Inside, he heard a robotic voice. It sounded like it was singing. It also sounded somehow familiar. In the hall, the snowtroopers were being joined by Kassido troopers. It was becoming an endless wave of more and more troops as the operatives were being chipped away. Viv stepped cautiously into the hallway, his blaster at the ready. The voice became more clear. It was singing hello in every known language in the galaxy. Rounding the corner, Viv spotted the silver head of a protocol droid sitting atop a desk. Wires were attached to every angle of it.
"Joe?"
Viv asked, approaching, happy to see his old friend.
"Oh, oh, 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 you have arrived. Dear sir, I am so deeply sorry. I can't believe you're still alive," Viv exclaimed. "I'm so very, very sorry for that.
What do you have to be sorry for? You're alive! We'll get you out of here!
I could not stop them, sir. They extracted everything from me.
What did they extract from you?
Everything, sir. Everything! I don't know how they got past the encoding, but they decoded all of my memory banks. The location of the base, who the rebels are, everything! You must leave quick!
Joe the droid's voice was cut short. Its eyes turned red, and it said in a completely different voice, "Rebel scum is to be eliminated!" Suddenly the doors closed and sealed shut. The fight in the hall was raging endlessly. More soldiers were entering the fight, and two commanders were behind them, General Barazon of Kassido and General Fortif of the Empire.
"Where is he?"
Pejix asked impatiently. Dom looked back and saw that the door Viv had gone through was shut and locked.
"It's a trap!"
he said.
"Hey, that's my line!"
Jihad said as he kept shooting. Inside the room, Viv was looking over the wires, figuring out how he could get Joe free. The odd voice was coming out of him, counting down from 10. But Joe was speaking in between the numbers.
10.
You must go, sir.
9.
You must break through the door.
8.
They set this up to kill you.
7.
I'm not leaving you behind, Joe, Viv insisted.
6.
You must, sir. They...
5.
Have rigged me to explode if you remove my head.
But not if I remove your memory chip, Viv said as he yanked Joe's mind core out of his head. He now only had 3 seconds. It wasn't enough time to get out of the room, but it was enough to get behind some furniture. So he ran to the opposite side of the room and hunkered down. Dom rushed to the doorway and tried to open it. As expected, it was locked. He heard and felt an explosion from within.
Viv!
He shouted, and he smashed open the wall pane to begin hacking it. He got one door open, and the inner one opened at the same time. Viv stumbled out, burned with his clothes singed, like he had just been cooked in an oven, and his card flipped. Yeah, Imperial salt is very forgiving. Anyway, Viv was barely alive, so they made their way back to a desk they hid behind. Pejix and Jihad were pinned down by the ever-increasing number of enemy troopers. They were even being flanked by probe droids. The time had come to act. Pejix told the others that he was going to push forward. They were to follow him and not stop, then run out the door and sprint to the room they had first gone into, then head for the ship. Everyone wanted to ask him what he was talking about, but he didn't wait. Utilizing 3 of his skills, we'll do anything, sneak attack, and one more thing all in a row, he rushed forward and shot the guards by the door. With the way cleared, Jihad ran past him into the cold outdoors. As he did, he saw the probe droids to his right still trying to get a shot at the other doorway. And ahead of him, he saw the elite guards of Kassido. Though they weren't known for their shooting skills, they wielded force pikes as well as the Emperor's personal guard. This really was a trap. Though a frightening and fascinating sight, Jihad did not linger to watch. He sprang at the doorway and dashed through. The guards were still firing at Pejix, and he was dodging many of their shots while the doctor slipped past and ran into the room with Jihad. The elite guard came in behind and stabbed Viv, but he slammed the door on their pikes, breaking one of them. Dom now pushed up behind Pejix, but there was nowhere to run. The elite guard had blocked their outer passage, and the probe droids would shoot down anything that ran outside. So they made a stand together in the hallway, distracting the guards while Viv and Jihad sprinted toward the front exit, behind the hallway soldiers. The elite guard forced their way in and spackled Jihad, wounding him to the point of turning over his card. Jihad was poured into action and he ran out the front. In the hallway, both Pejix and Dom had their cards turned over as they were pummeled with shots. "You see that gap between the engineers?" Pejix asked. Dom nodded. "Bull rush it," he shouted. And without waiting for Dom to protest, Pejix fired a slew of shots into the workers. While the enemy was focused on Pejix, Dom bull-rushed the engineers and pushed past, heading for the door. He got to the front entrance with the others. Pejix jumped out of the doorway and sprinted between the probe droids and the elite guards. They held their fire as they didn't want to hit each other, and in this game you have to wait until your turn. Pejix used all remaining energy to make it around the corner of the building into a narrow alley between the building and a steep rise in the ground. As such, only one probe droid at a time was able to follow him, and even then it was scraping the sides. At the front, the operatives were racing for the ship. The guards were sharp on their tails. General Barazon was with them, and calmly took aim, hitting Dom in the back every few seconds. Dom's strength was waning. The others encouraged him to keep going, but when the others passed the small house and were almost to the ship, General Barazon stopped, leveled his blaster pistol, and fired. It was a fatal blow right into the back of Dom. He fell face down in the snow. Viv looked back horrified. He began to run back, but Jihad grabbed him.
"He's dead!"
he shouted.
"It was a trap and he's dead! We have to go!"
"No!"
Viv shouted, but he stopped, feeling the weight of the droid's memory bank in his hands. This had Joe in it. And what was more, it had a warning. The rebel base was going to be attacked. Its location had been pulled from Joe's memory banks. It was important that Viv warn them. So he got into the ship with Jahat, and they took off. Princess Lyra asked where the others were. Jahat just flew, and Viv sat, stroking the droid's memory bank. Below, they could see their friend's lifeless body lying face down in the snow. And as they flew over the building, they could not find Pejix. The last he had been seen, he was being chased by three probe droids, and Kassido's most elite guard. He was presumed dead. They had lost half their operatives. The others were severely injured. They had not found what they had come for. But as Jahat insisted, it had been a trap. General Barazan had figured out that King Jaros had approved the design of powerful weapons, and he had begun production on them himself. But rather than keeping his work in plain sight, he had moved it to a location Lyra would never know about. He had left her alive so she would inadvertently lead the operatives who rescued her right into his trap. He had expected all of them to wind up in the room with the exploding droid head, and hadn't counted on any of them being able to escape. But he had gotten two of them, and nothing was going to stop them from their next move, for they had discovered the location of the hidden rebel base, and a fleet of Imperial and Kassido ships and transports were gathering in the Carsanza system, ready for an invasion to finish them off, once and for all. If you enjoyed this video, please thumb us below and let your friends know. Also put in the comments anything you think the characters should have done differently. Click on the next video to continue watching the story, and you can find other stories written by the author in the description below. May the Force be with you, and happy gaming, everybody!